Assalamu alaikum. This is Ms. Zahra Khurram. I am from TAFS and I am here to teach you about the topography of Pakistan. The first chapter of your syllabus 20592, Environment of Pakistan. Here we are starting with the chapter and making an effort that you people, by staying at home, get the maximum output from TAFS and the efforts being made from your school. So let's start without wasting any more time. Here we are with the chapter Topography of Pakistan. Actually, this chapter, NCIE's, not generally comes as a whole question, which is a scenario for every chapter, you know. But this chapter is much important as it connects different chapter. For example, topography is connected to agriculture, topography is connected to transport, topography connects climate as well. Topography is definitely affecting the population and its density as well. So topography is present in every chapter. Without understanding the land of Pakistan, the relief and drainages of Pakistan, it's not possible to develop the economic structures and further details of different chapters. So we are starting with that. First of all, what is topography? Topography means topography, the collection of two words. Topo means surface and graphy means study. So in this chapter, we are going to study about the surface of Pakistan. In that surface, mind it that we are here about the natural topography. On the surface of Pakistan, yes, we have hospitals, yes, we have schools, yes, we have dams, yes, we have other things as well. But in this chapter, we are only concentrating about on the natural topography that is naturally present. For example, mountains, for example, rivers, for example, plains, deserts, and many more. So if we divide Pakistan's topographic region, you can take help from your map in the book, which is on the very first page of your chapter. Here we have six topographic regions. How many? Six topographic regions of Pakistan. The first one is northern and northwestern mountains. Second one is western mountains, then Balochistan plateau, then Potwar and Salt Range. Then it's Indus Plain and desert areas. Now what we have to study? It's a huge chapter. It looks huge, it looks big, it looks difficult, but it's not. Believe me, it's not. What you have to do, you have to concentrate, like there are four things you need to study about all these six regions. Four things about all these six regions. For northern and northwestern mountains, four things. Then this four, 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 and four, right? What are those four things? Here, for each topographic region, you need to understand about its relief. Relief, the land, the climate, the altitude, the surface, how it is, right? Secondly, you have to understand drainage. Pani kahan se aata hai, kaise aata hai, kahan jata hai, kaise jata hai. Right? We'll come to the details and you will get to know. Third thing is that you need to understand the economic potential of that area. How that area is economically potential. What are the potentials or what are the things from which that area can earn money, can earn something and develop the economy. And the fourth one is economy is there. Potential is there, but what are the problems of developing that economy? People are facing the problem. For example, we know Karachi has a huge potential of development of economy. But do we have problems here? Yes, we have political problems here. We have shutdowns and strikes here. We have a huge population here which require a huge amount of employment which we are unable to generate. So these are the problems of this area, right? Potential is there, but the problems are also there. So what we are going to do is that about all these six areas, we need to understand these four things, right? Now let's start we will be unable to cover all six regions in one sitting, right? In one lecture, it will not be possible to cover all six. Yes, but I will try to cover two most important areas, and then in next lecture, two more important rest, you study and give us the feedback that what problems you are facing, what you more want to know, and then what exactly this solve your problems, this solve your queries or not. Remember one thing. In the past papers, there is no individual question regarding topography, but yes, there are chunks and parts in each question. It's related to every single chapter, and it is also seen that some chunks, for example, maybe of 5, 6, or 7 marks, there are questions in chunks present from topography directly. For example, if you see 2018 and 2017's paper, there are chunks of topography there directly. Indus Delta ka aapke paas map hai, and you have to identify which area is this, right? So we are going to prepare for this. Now let's start. We are starting with Northern Mountains and Northwestern Mountains. First of all, you understand the directions, right? North, South. And those who face difficulty in West and East, for them, it's what's the spelling of we? We, hum. English mein we ki spelling kya hoti hai? That is W-E. Alright? So put it here. W-E. If you know North, you will get the West and East. Right? If North is here, put a perpendicular. W-E. Simple, right? So first of all, you understand the direction: north, south, west, and east. So when we talk about Pakistan, for example, right? When we talk about Pakistan, we talk about northern areas. Northern areas, these are northern areas. This is west. So what is northwest? This direction is northwest, right? So the mountains which we are talking about, northern and northwestern areas, are actually present in this area and this area, right? Okay. So in northern mountains and northwestern mountains, there are actually, now what we have to study? We have to study these four things about northern and northwestern mountains. Fine? The northern and northwestern mountains, first thing which we are learning about northern and northwestern mountains are relief. What is the relief? Kaisi hai wo jagah? Wo jagah kaisi hai? Number one, high mountainous peaks. Right? Number two, steep slopes. What is steep slopes? Steep. This is steep. This slant, this is steep, steep slopes. Now if the slopes are steep, mountains are high, this is one mountainous peak, this is another mountainous peak, the valley will be deep, deep valleys, right? High mountains, steep slopes, deep valleys, rugged landscape, these are all relief features. Pareshan hone ki koi baat hi nahi hai, tension ki koi cheez hi nahi hai, aapko sab pata hai. So these are relief structures. Aur kya hai? High peaks. Snow covered? Yes, snow covered. Fine. So these are relief features of northern mountains. Northern and northwestern mountains. Now, one thing which you need to study and which you need to remember is that in northern areas, there are actually three ranges. Wo bachpan mein hum banaya karte the, yaad hai? Scenery banate the. Art ki teacher hame scenery banane ke liye kehti thi. Hum scenery banate the aise. Aise. Remember? So this is one mountain. This is another mountain. mountain peak. This all is mountainous range. The collection of mountainous peaks is mountainous range, right? So we have three huge, huge ranges in Pakistan in northern and northwestern mountains, right? Those three ranges are, come on, name them. Name them, try to name them. Yes, that is number one, Himalayas. Number two, Karakoram. And number three, Hindu Kush. In these three mountains, in these three mountainous ranges, as I told you, that we have north and northwest. Sorry. North and northwest. So north we have Himalayas and Karakoram. And in northwest we have Hindu Kush. They are junction on one point here. Right? Hindu Kush, Himalayas and Karakoram. All three ranges are collectively known as northern and northwestern mountains. The highest peak in Pakistan is of Karakoram. Remember, I am telling the highest peak of Karakoram, of Pakistan, not of world. Of world, it's from Himalayas, Mount Everest. But in Pakistan, the highest peak is K2, Godwin Austin. Right? So, rest are in Himalayas, Nanga Parbat, Trichmere, and other high mountainous peaks are also present. These names you have to remember. These names you need to write, for example, in your 6-mark question or something, whenever it is needed. But these are the approximate heights of these, the average heights of these mountains are 4,000, 5,000, and 6,000 meters above the sea level. This all you need to remember, right? This all you need to remember? Yes. Now come to, you must read the book. You must read the book, right? For extra knowledge for the, but I'm telling you, I only want to tell you that it's not difficult, right? Don't worry about it. You need to study the basic features that you have already learned. The second thing is drainage. Pani kahan se aaya aur kidhar gaya? Kaise aaya aur kaise gaya? Right? In mountainous areas, what do you know that how water comes and how water travels? The water travels from the snowfall, glaciers melt, form rivers, springs, and waterfalls, gorges, that's it. The Indus water and tributaries of Indus water are fed by these glaciers. That's it, drainage is over. Now what about the economic potential? The third thing, what about the economic potential? What do you know that how these people earn? Why people are living there, people are earning there. How they are earning? What is their potential? Number one, the biggest potential of the northern areas. Yes, that is tourism, right? Another economic potential there, that is agriculture. Not like in this plain, yes, but agriculture is there. You must have heard, dry fruits upar se aate hain, huh? Right. Third thing, agriculture, it includes livestock farming as well, okay? Livestock, transhumance, let's say, plus. However, we include transhumance in agriculture, yes, but I have written it so that you know. Tourism, agriculture, any other thing of northern areas, what we earn from there, right? These are? Gems, we have fifth largest deposit of gems in northern areas of Pakistan. Yes, we have international borders. Trade. Fine? So these are the economic potential of those areas. We know that people are learning from there. Now, these are the potentials. But don't you think that people are facing problems in earning those these things? Yes, they are having problems. What problems do they face? Tourism to hai. Tourism to hai. Lekin hamara tourism kyun develop nahi hota? Log kyun Switzerland jaate hain, Pakistan nahi aate? Kya problem hai? Unko lagta hai ki yahan pe roads acche nahi bane hue. Yahan pe light chali jayegi. First aid facilities nahi hai, hospitals nahi hai stop par. The infrastructure is weak. Our infrastructure is weak. That is the problem in developing our economy. Half of the year, the roads are blocked because of avalanches and slides, landslides. So that is the problem in developing our tourism. For agriculture, what is the problem for agriculture? We know that half of the time, the areas of the northern areas and northwestern areas are covered with snow. The fields are covered with snow. Agriculture cannot be done. Simple. So secondly, this problem occurs that the whole year agriculture cannot be done. The third thing is mining of gems. In that area, we will learn about the mining of gems in mineral deposits and the chapter of mineral resources of Pakistan, that we have various problems there. We do not have technology. We do not have expert miners. We do not have that money or capital to invest in that thing. And rest is Silk Route trade. That is again the trade that is because of roads, and that is a hurdle for that. Okay. Now we are coming to another one more topic among these. We will take the smaller one. We will take the smaller one, and that is desert areas, right? Now again, desert areas, you all know what are desert areas. Fine. Desert areas, tell me the relief. Come on, hurry up. What is the relief? Desert areas relief. Desert areas relief is that barren, no vegetation, no trees, barren sand dunes, matti ke bade bade teele hain, rolling sand dunes that move with wind from one place to another, right? So sand dunes moving from one place to another, that is relief, right? That is relief. No vegetation, bare vegetation, fine. What is drainage? Pani kahan se aata hai, kahan jata hai? Aata hi kahan hai? Saal mein, do saal mein thodi thodi si barish hoti hai. So drainage is what? No sufficient supply of water, lack of rainfall, lack of water resources. That is drainage. Economic potential kya hai? Economic potential kya hai? Our deserts are rich. Our deserts are rich in mineral resources of power generation. Like Thar is very much rich in lignite. Thar has that much lignite that it can provide 300 years of free electricity to Pakistan. 200 years of free electricity of Pakistan. You have learned it in power resources, right? So it means that economic potential is present in our desert areas. Another economic potential of desert areas is that the people live their nomadic life. But yes, they are very good livestock farmers. They keep goats, they keep sheep. That results in generation of revenue by, number one, the generation of economy, number one, skin, meat, and many other things that are fulfilled there. Next is, now what is the problem of developing economy? We all know, deserts mein aap rehna chahte hain? Main rehna chahti hoon, kyun? Jab log nahi honge, to economy kaise develop hogi? Deserts mein aap roads nahi bana sakte, railway tracks nahi dal sakte. Aap machine hi nahi chalengi wahan pe. Aap deserts ke andar jo hai wo industries lagana mushkil ho jata hai, kyunki industry ka ek sole important cheez hoti hai, that is water. We require water for that industry, and we do not have water resources there, right? That is a hurdle. Phir itna severe climatic condition, rainfall nahi hai, water resource nahi hai, that will not support the human activities. So this is what the problems in developing economy there. Okay, so we have covered two of our important topics, that is northern and northwestern and desert areas. I require your feedback, and stay connected, prepare yourself best, and all the best for your CIEs. Allah Hafiz.